Pretty sure it's done nothing but rain since about September. End of September, October time. Nothing but damp and wet and miserably. Quite hard to get any sense of motivation. Face of all this shit. Yeah, splash up with my fucking glasses. Oh god, it's fucking wet, isn't it? Morning. Wet chalk and grip are not words often used in the same sentence. I don't know about how wet that bit was. I am going to be mincing down this hill. Oh, I think it's going to never seem to shut. Right, let's see how much of a nightmare this is going to be, shall we? Falling off on camera. That'd be quite embarrassing, really. Oh, yeah, look at this. Oh, watering. Choice, the wet chalk or the slippery mud in the middle. Bit of a Hobson choice. Well, that tree's been cleared, it was right there. Oh, something at least. Oh, speed adjustment, grip on the corner. Will it all go horribly wrong? No, not at all. The Royal Oak, yeah. Not a bad little pub. One of my favourites in the summer. The lovely fish and chips. The daffs are out, see a little semblance of spring. Maybe a little bit warmer, mind you, warm the sun. It's not massively warm anywhere else. That oak isn't translating to dry trails yet. If I got out first thing it might have been okay, but as it's thawed a little bit, it's not the nicest. Gotta love a good 29 inch wheel, rolls over everything. Fortunately, an 800 mil bar doesn't fit through everything. This gap being one of them. Narrow thoughts. So it's across the road, it's heading up around the other side of the Devil's Dyke. I'll spare you footage of me puffing and wheezing up a hill. It's certainly not particularly graceful. Only another am I. I spotted a lot of things, a little bit of moisture on the lens, in the lens as well. Hope not. This is the third use of a week old GoPro. I'd be quite angry if it's a moisture in the lens. But we'll see. Get home and have a look at it. Good night as well. Go on Google. Fixes everything. Oh, shall I be getting one over here? Muddy little hill, this one. Spun back in recent weeks, so it's not quite as snaggy as it used to be. I guess used a lot by horse riders. That can be quite chunky. As you can see, I'm running out of grip already. Fuck it. Fucking dog walk. So fucking muddy. It's got past our little sludge fest. Massively cut up by horses. Well, this time of year, it's just been so wet. And everything is just literally porridge, pretty much. Every trail you go to. Unless, I don't think for a UK mountain biker, unless you live somewhere near Pease Lake or Surrey Hills, where it's a bit sandy. Or Swinley, that kind of ground. So hard to motivate yourself to go riding slop. And I grew up in Dartmoor. I don't remember ever being quite so claggy as this. I think Sussex is quite clay based. Could be wrong. I could be being miserable because it's wet and muddy. I wasn't quite expecting it to be quite so grotty as it is. Probably the case. I'm being a grumpy bastard. I think it's fair enough. All things considered. Oh dear. Anyway. I'll take you down to Saddlescombe Farm. There's a little climb back up the dike. And a steady spin home. Downhill all the way, thankfully. There's the gate. There's past a little bit of slop. Oh dear. Random Garmin's and phone making beeping noises. I don't want to ride with earphones in. I've got to play those little M-Pow true wireless earbuds. Like 25 quid off Amazon. And to be honest, they're not too bad. But the problem with them is just the Bluetooth connection is so... well, shit, basically. If I have them in my bum bag, then one ear pod or the other is constantly dropping out of connection. It's just a pain in the ass. All the ears. One thing I hate is just having cables dangling everywhere. It's a pain in the neck really, but then it's the more expensive ones have better Bluetooth connections. This is just for bum bag, around my waist, my ears, maybe just 2.5 feet. They're not exactly a massive distance or, you know, a brick wall between the two of them. It's just quite frustrating, really. There is something to be said for just listening to the sounds of nature and the sound of the bike when you're out for a ride. Maybe not such a squelchy shell like today, but you know, summer, that little kind of hollow rumbling from the wheels, that's quite satisfying. Puffed and puffed up the steep bit of the hill. Now this is the last little steady climb up to the gate where I dropped in earlier on. This seems to be turning into something of a blog really. Which is kind of cool. Not quite what I envisaged. No ride doing, but you know. No plan meets contact with the enemy and all that. Yeah. Oh, dogs. What the little ones, isn't it? Not like I see much. I've got so much sweat on my glasses, I can't see anything. Quite frustrating, eh? Really. Oh, they're going to move out of the way. I don't know if they're going to stand in the way. They're going to stand in the way. Cheers. Most dog walkers around here are pretty cool. Some of them can be right awkward bastards, though. I've got the bell on the handlebar, you know, in that. No situations. But some of them, there's no concept of control over the dogs. You know, don't say that most things, you know, cyclists going too fast, whatever. Dogs, you know, there's a bad. There are bad apples in every bunch. I think. I like to think, you know, most cyclists have no way of control over the bike. But not every dog is under control from its owner. The worst ones are that the dogs come squealing up to your barking and whatever. They're always friendly. Well, not everyone's going to respond to a charging animal. In a particularly favourable way, couldn't they? Yeah. No, it's rather charging to be. I'm terrified of the dogs for the same reason. Same goes for the dog walking companies you get around here. There are a couple of cool ones. Don't know the names of them, but there's a lady who has one. Long girl. She's had a massive Cossack cat on. She keeps everything under control, but I've gone around and found packs of wild dogs running around everywhere. Completely out of control. That's before we even forget on the subject of dog poo. I think Waterfall Golf Course, a couple of miles away from where we are. About miles of coastline, probably. Bit of a mecca for the dog walking, it's basically a big field. And the amount of poo bags I find on the floor. They've actually taken the time to pick it up, bag it, and left it in the bush or hanging off a branch. And I'm like, what the actual fuck? There's right on my tits. Bad enough wiping all the mud off this time of year, let alone all the crusty dog doo and other favourites. Oh dear. Towards the Garmin in my high aerobic zone. Feels like I'm blowing up my arse today. Which is a visceral image for everyone, I'm sure. Certainly people that know me can ask me. Take me down to the road. Oh shit. Down to the road. Steady spin back. Blast the hose over the big chunks of mud. Right lens is currently in sweat. Left lens, perfectly fine. It's always my right lens. Anyway, that's all the mud done with anyway. Actually, the bike's awesome because it's not too bad. Luckily, we've got dirty, great big down tube, so put the old Cannondale Super V's. That's quite an effective mud guard. Anyway, enough of me complaining about my ride. I'll see you on the next one.